lycanthropy, fact or fiction? Some say yes, some say no. Others have no idea what it is in the first place. In this documentary, we shall examine these controversial issues and examine the social ramifications, the cultural underpinnings, and in no small way, the veterinary aspects of this extraordinary, perhaps mythical, perhaps not, phenomenon. My name is Sebastian Armband Keepsake Perkins, and I'm about to take you on a journey so dark, so disturbing, so altogether strange, that many may find it nauseating, while others will find it quite simply smashing.
Before we further delve into the specifics of the case at hand, let us first be clear as to the meaning and indeed the absurdity of the word lycanthropy itself, being as it is lexically underemployed by the general public. Lycanthropy, unlike the werewolf, is a very broad concept, encompassing as it does the full range of human to animal metamorphoses in which the person thus afflicted supposedly transforms into a ferocious animal, a fearsome predator who in turn preys upon his fellow man. The exact type of ferocious beast, and this then is the key, differs right round the world. In Europe itself, it is the wolf or bear, in Asia the tiger, in Africa the leopard or giraffe, and in Australia the duck-billed platypus. But in the annals of lycanthropy, there is surely none stranger than the case of Joey Hyman, a man who believes he is a Tyrannosaurus rex. Throughout his protracted childhood, Joey Hyman was strange. Despite an otherwise normal upbringing and the sexual abuse, the young lad never spoke and rarely uttered any sort of audible sound whatsoever, articulated or otherwise. He did, however, exhibit a remarkable proclivity for drawing disturbing images. Examined by some of the best medical professionals in their price range, Joey's parents were daunted in their hopes of ever finding a remedy for the boy's weird behavior. Only Joey's older brother Edgar seemed able to understand the troubled boy, and when their parents at last abandoned Joey, Edgar took over as key caregiver. It is here that we pick up the story. I traveled to the remote regions of the United States in the petrified state of North Carolina where Joey and Edgar make their summertime residence. With me was my documentary film crew of the past 16 years, cameraman Fernando de Puerto Puerto Cuervos and soundman Hank Smegma. Together, we had covered many a remarkable and controversial story, but we could all sense that this was something special. The smell of excitement filled the big-ass American truck as we sped toward our goal. This was to be it. After many phone calls and over 4,000 miles of coach-class travel, I would finally have the opportunity of an actual on-camera interview with Edgar and Joey, Joey T-Rex. I must confess my uncharacteristic anxiousness at the prospect of meeting Joey in person. When I first caught sight of the Hyman homestead, I felt a sudden, unexpected tension, a pensiveness that I hadn't previously experienced and which quite shook me. Was it the excitement? Was it the small, dead, and half-mutilated animal we spied in the front yard as we pulled in?
I had never before been acquainted with fear, but this time, it seemed to be making its acquaintance with me. There was just a touch of foreboding, like something altogether strange was about to happen. It was just waiting for a release, and I could not shrink away from it.
Mr. Hyman! Mr. Hyman! Mr. Hyman! This is Sebastian Perkins. We spoke on the phone.
Bologna sandwich.
There you go, buddy. There you go.
Sorry about that incident earlier. I was in the back, didn't hear you pull up.
Oh, no need to apologize. I quite understand Joey's condition, but you understand I was more than a little bit startled, to say the least.
You think you were startled. Jehovah's Witness lady actually left a trail of piss on my steps. Stain's still there if you want to get a shot of it.
Oh, that is probably due to the ammonia in the urine which bleached the wood. But that's irrelevant.
I'd like to discuss Joey's condition. When did this condition first manifest itself?
Well, Joey's never been quite right. He never could talk. The whole thing started when he was about 8 or 9 with the T-Rex. We told the doctors it was that damn Land of the Lost, the TV show. Yeah, Joey used to watch that shit all the time.
That is interesting. Autistic children sometimes emulate animal characteristics, such as drinking out of the family dog water bowl.
Oh, Joey's artistic, all right. Just look at all the drawings.
No. Autistic, not artistic.
Whatever. He sure does like to draw.
Judging from the incident when we arrived, I see that Joey can sometimes exhibit violent tendencies. However, when we talked on the phone, you assured me that Joey was altogether docile.
Well, normally he is. It's that damn Land of the Lost thing again. A friend of mine let us borrow the new movie, the one with Will Ferrell in it. And I hid the DVD, but Joey found it while I was at work.
You mean he's capable of operating electronic equipment by himself?
Oh, Joey ain't no dumbass. He wired up my home theater system.
That is interesting. This means he's capable of higher cognitive skills than even I had previously assumed.
Yeah, and this is the second system he wired up. Yeah, he kind of tore up the first one. I came home from work and the whole damn house was tore up when he watched the movie. Yeah, the fucker even took a shit on the DVD. I guess he didn't like the ending.
Then, judging from your own comments, then, Joey often exhibits violent tendencies?
Oh, stay. 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 Good boy. Oh, Joey's a good boy.
He's never harmed anyone?
No.
Well, what about the incident when we arrived?
He was just playing with you boys. But there was this one time. I took Joey to the Chunk E. Cheese playing the ball pit. He likes to have balls up to his chin.
I bet he does.
Be professional, Fernando.
Yeah, well, there was a guy dressed as a big purple dinosaur there. Joey saw it as a challenge. Needless to say, the little girl's birthday party turned into a blood fest. Well, we had to leave in a hurry, so I got pulled over for speeding. Cop was an asshole, made us both get out of the car. And, well, Joey got upset while he was questioning me, tackled him, took a bite out of his head.
Interesting.
Yeah, I never would have thought you could take a bite out of a man's head.
And what was the outcome of this incident?
Oh, 129 stitches for the cop, 2 years house arrest for Joey. I had to pay off the speeding ticket. We got banned from Chunk E. Cheese, so I don't know what happened to the purple dinosaur. I think they knew Joey was a little off and just trying to protect me, so they took it easy on him.
After concluding the interview, our visit to the Hyman household ended much as it started.
Let's get out of here.
Man, drive!
After the interview, I tried to contact the Hyman brothers by phone. After repeated attempts to no avail, and several months later, I decided to drop by their home. I would like to say that the reason for the visit was to check on their well-being, but actually, I had to put my suspicions to rest. While in the editing bay, I began to wonder if the Hyman brothers simply scammed me out of $100 they were promised and paid for compensation. Was I simply duped by just a couple of yahoos? After the visit, I went over the footage of the interview to see if I could find on the wall that same compelling drawing of the T-Rex whose shackles were broken and which I had found crumpled on the sofa. The image which so vividly portrayed Joey's elation at being freed. Nothing. The last few weeks have grown wearisome for me. I've stopped eating. My mood has become increasingly disagreeable and my friends have found my company difficult to bear. I fear a loathsome change has come upon me, and my work is suffering. I no longer find joy in documenting these stories. I have withdrawn to the sanctuary of my estate and avoid the company of others. This is likely to be the last record I make, for I find a protracted stagnation creeping into my body and filling my veins like a lustful apathy. The only desire I have left is to draw the terrible images that fill my restless mind, and a burgeoning hunger for bologna sandwiches. God help me.